Marriages don't last. 52% of marriages end in divorce. And they say it's because of infidelity or finances. But I think most people get a divorce because the husband doesn't believe the wife when she tells him that their house is haunted. It's the plot of every ghost story. First, little kid sees the ghost, doesn't say anything. Then the wife sees the ghost, tells her husband, and then he says something dismissive like, "Oh, there's no such thing as haunted houses. Ghosts don't exist. You're just being emotional. Women are emotional. Are you on your period?" I don't know why the husband sounds like sexist Jimmy Stewart, but we're gonna roll with it. And then halfway through the movie, he'll see the ghost, and then all of a sudden he's like, "Oh, hey, honey, this place is haunted. You were right." And for me, if I were the wife in this scenario, the whole movie would stop right there and I'd get real petty. I'd be like, "Oh, I'm sorry, I thought I just heard you say that I was right after you essentially called me crazy, crossing the line, talking about my lady time. Now you want to say that I'm right. You get on your knees. You get on your knees and you crawl over here and you say it in my good ear." Then a ghost would pop up and be like, "I'll kill you all." And I'll be like, "Yo, hold up a minute, ghost. I do believe my husband was in the middle of a long overdue apology. Let me hear it." Because marriages are based on trust. And you're gonna believe somebody on Yelp about a Chinese restaurant, but you won't believe your wife when she says there's a shadow demon in the living room. I am better than Yelp. I am your wife. We're getting a divorce. I want to be a vampire. Sounds like a pretty good deal to me. You never get any older, never age, never die. Fantastic, sign me up. But I would appreciate a 6-month heads up. You know. Just so I could really hit the gym. Drop the baby weight. Maybe get a spray tan. This is eternity we're talking about, man. I wanna look my best. Hey, here's a question. Can you smoke pot and eat cheesecake when you're a vampire? Because if you can, that's what I'm doing for the next 2,000 years. That's what I'm doing. And if you can't, then I am just going to eat people who just ate cheesecake. I'll be perched on top of Cheesecake Factory like Christopher Walken in The Prophecy, waiting for families to come out, rip out a tourist's throat, and be like, a tuxedo cheesecake, my favorite. I love scary movies, man. I love them. And I love going to see them in the theater because it's the only time it's ever appropriate to yell the phrase, "Kill that fucking kid in public." Because you can yell it during The Exorcist, but you can't yell it at Albertsons. They will ask you to leave. And you will not get your groceries. It's not fair. A friend of mine said that I shouldn't reference The Exorcist in that joke because, you know, it's just so long ago, and I don't think people are going to get the reference. You know, for me, it's just a little before my time. Well, incidentally, it was before my time too, but I've seen it. A lot of things were before my time, like fire, the Constitution, the wheel. But I know what the fuck they are. So don't act like you're young and I'm old and you're cool, but I'm not, because I will put you in a fucking box. Before my time.